She will be 15. And the daddy Seahawk is only 4. The Pittsburgh Zoo is one of the few zoos in the country with breeding sea lions. And with Sydney being born last year, there will be 2 bouncing baby pups.
This is the proud Papa Seahawk vocalizing for keepers.
That's one of the greetings that sea lions do to each other. They blow raspberries on each other.
Maggie, plenty fit after almost 11 months gestation, is due to give birth in mid-June.
And if you look really closely, you will see, it's hard for me to see from here, a beating heart right there. His head, the animal's head, I don't know if it's a girl or boy yet.
The pup will be joining this year-old girl, Sydney, named after Sidney Crosby, since she was born the day the Penguins won the Stanley Cup. Her mother is Zoe.
Zoe's not real happy with Hawk these days. She tries to avoid him.
But Hawk and Maggie are sticking pretty close, which is what the pup will have to do after it's born.
As soon as the pup comes out, and if the pup is healthy and active, then the pup vocalizes a great deal. It calls constantly for the female. And if the female immediately goes to the pup, reacts to that vocalization, and then does the proper behavior at that time, then we would anticipate the behavior, the bonding goes well.
But Maggie's looking great.
Sea lions are what we call delayed implanters. So they'll breed in June or July of the year before, and then according to the conditions, they can actually delay implantation. So they can wait until conditions are right, till food's available in the wild, for example, until they're able to get in a nice beach area before they actually deliver.
Here at the Pittsburgh Zoo, that won't be a problem.
Sea lions characteristically lose 10 to 15% of their pups after birth. That is why that first week of bonding is so critical. But Maggie and Zoe had Zoe and Sydney to watch last year, and Zoe was a great maternal example. And by the way, Wendy said that Maggie is a cougar. Sally Wiggin, Channel 4 Action News.